So I think we just do two passes. It's very similar to house robber one. Except, okay, now they're in a circle. Just make sure this is gonna work. Wait, what? Yeah, so the only thing that changes is we can't rob the first and the last. So the only thing that changes is we can't rob the first and the last. That's it, I think. Is there a slicker way to do this than just a bunch of conditional logic? Okay, yeah, so we can just like try it. The maximum between host robber one function on everything but the last, and the host robber function on everything but the first. Honestly, I think that's just what I'm gonna do. Alright, so let's do our like edge cases first. So if not nums. Just get out, and we're gonna define house robber one. And it's just gonna take, I'll use a different variable name, sure. And then, yeah, so now we just have to define house robber one exactly the same. So, if not, the best way to do this. Simple DP. I'm not gonna do like the space optimized one just because it's easier to come up with. Space complexity is gonna suffer. It's gonna be linear space complexity instead of constant, but that's okay. We'll take that. Could be optimized further, but it's okay. So, all right, so just iterate. Previous. Two previous. It's gonna get a little loud. Alright, let's just change this song. Two previous. Maximum between robbing the current house, skipping the current house, So that's house robber one. That's if we don't have this restriction, the circular restriction, or not restriction, not restriction, but this wrinkle about them being a circle. Okay, so then return the maximum of this function called on everything but the first. And HR1. Maybe I can fix that. Hey, 21. After your bracket. Yup. Goofed. What did that edge case feel? Like, how did I get why it's wrong? How could we elegantly work that in? Okay, so there's only one house. Ooh, yeah, I did not think about that. Sure. Because, yeah, this house isn't adjacent to itself.